heard the saying, he's carrying a lot of baggage from his past, or watch out for her, baggage. But think about it, baggage. We get it from other people by the things they say to us, or really even do to us. And if we carry these things around, in essence, we carry around baggage. We begin collecting baggage when we're just little kids.
Hey.
Hi, what's going on?
I need to talk to you.
Sure, what's up?
Well, I was talking with the gang, and I was like a spokesperson.
Okay, what's the gang doing?
Well, we're gonna build a treehouse.
Cool, I've always wanted to build a treehouse.
You're not gonna get to, though.
What? Why?
You just aren't, that's it.
Why can't I?
Well, we took a vote, and you'll weigh us down.
What do you mean we'll weigh you down?
You're too fat.
What?
Yeah, for a five-year-old, you're pretty happy.
Mommy just says I'm chunky.
No, peanut butter's chunky. You're fat.
Mommy says I have big bones.
Dinosaurs have big bones. You're fat.
Mommy says I've lost a lot of weight recently.
I think you found it again. Sorry.
You've heard that sticks and stones may break my bones, but words will never hurt me? Well, guess what? It's one of the biggest lies I've ever been taught. Words can cut so deep, and if we don't learn to let go, and we find our self-worth based on what other people think of us, and not who we are in Christ, then what we do is just pick up more baggage. Sometimes, we pick up baggage from someone very close to us, like a best friend.
Hey, Shelly. Look, I know I was supposed to talk to you about my friend, but we talked for like 3 hours yesterday, and I really feel like we clicked, and I really feel like you're my density, and, you know, I meant destiny. And I know we don't know each other very well, but I think I love you. I mean, I love you so much that I even wrote a song for you. Oh, Shelly, you are so pretty. I'm still working on the words, but you know, it's fine. And I thought about taking a picture of me with a guitar because I just thought it would be cool. And so, I gotta go. Hey, what's up, best bud?
Not much, dude. Who was that?
My mom.
Okay, you were singing a song to your mom?
Yeah, my mom likes music.
Okay, that's cool, but I thought I heard you say Shelly.
I did. That's my mom's name, Shelly.
I thought your mom's name was Kelly.
It is. Shelly's just her middle name.
Your mom's name is Kelly Shelly?
Yep. That's why I had to sing to her, because she feels bad about her name. Yeah.
Okay, that's cool. Anyway, have you gotten a chance to talk to Shelly?
Like, the Shelly you like?
My Shelly?
Yeah, we talked.
And?
Well, you see, she's not really going to be your Shelly. She's kind of going to be my Shelly. But look, don't let this come between us.
No, you look. I asked you to talk to this girl for me. I told you since we were kids that I liked this girl. Are you telling me that you guys talked for a couple hours last night, and now you're going out?
It's not like that. We just really hit it off. Don't let this come between us.
What do you mean, don't let this come between us?
We're best buds. We've been best buds since kindergarten.
Did she like me at all?
She says she just wants to be your friend.
She just wants to be my friend. I'd rather roll around on tacks and soak in lemon juice than just be her friend. What are you doing?
We're friends forever. Don't let this come between us.
Forever just got a lot shorter. You're supposed to be my best friend. Your friends are just trying to live life, just like you are. And they may make some poor decisions, and we may get hurt by it. But if we don't learn to forgive, what we do is we just pick up more baggage. The truth about baggage is, we don't really need other people to dump it on us. We do a pretty good job of picking it up ourselves when we think things like, I'll never be as popular as they are, or I'll never be as good at sports as they are, or I'll never be as talented as they are. When we buy into those thoughts in our heads, what we do is pick up more baggage. Or we end up thinking things like, why is life so easy for them and so hard for me? When we buy into those lies, more baggage. It becomes uncomfortable, tedious. Sometimes, we can get baggage from people who love us dearly. They just don't realize that their words can cut like a knife.
Son?
Hey, Dad.
What happened out there today?
I don't know. The light got in my eyes and the ball slipped.
The light got in your eyes. You lost the game because of that right there.
I know.
The light got in your eyes?
The ball slipped.
The ball slipped. How many times have we practiced at 5 a.m. in the morning before I went to work and you went to school? Don't you realize there were college scouts out there?
The ball slipped, Dad.
Oh, hey, Coach. What? No. Butterfingers. You're still going to play, right? Right? No problem? Yeah, we'll work on it. Are you crying?
No.
Just get your stuff.
Dad, the ball slipped.
I said, enough, get your stuff. Is it okay for me to be disappointed? These are our dreams, right?
Our parents, they don't mean to hurt us. It's just that they've got their own baggage. When we don't deal with baggage, we pass it on. And for us, if we find our identity in anything other than a relationship with Christ, we just pick up more baggage, and it becomes, well, uncomfortable. Our natural tendency is to want to dump our baggage onto someone else, but it always backfires.
Hey, big brother! I was just wondering if you could take...
Time out. Okay, time out. Did you just run into my room? You didn't knock, you didn't ask, you didn't say anything. You know that's not how you act. Go back out.
Can I come in?
Yes.
I was just wondering if you could take me and my friends to school.
You are not doing this.
What?
Listen, just because you and your little dweeb friends are going to be in high school now doesn't mean that you and I are going to hang out. Because I don't want anyone to know that you're my little sister. Because you're a freak. People look at you and they think she's a freak. And if they find out we're related, now I'm a freak too. So guess what? I don't care how you get to school. I don't care if you walk, if you crawl, but I'm not your chauffeur, got it?
It's not my fault that Dad left. Why do you keep taking it out on me?
Whatever.
You know I'm right.
Okay, I'm sorry.
You're not sorry. You're sorry that I called you out. I'll just ride my bike.
I said I'm sorry. In the midst of dumping baggage off on someone else, we just collect more. And then I have this sin, my secret sin. And it's cool, because nobody knows about it. But right when I think I've got it under control, maybe he's got control over me. So we live our lives, and right when we think we've got it all balanced out, maybe no one can really tell. But sometimes it gets unbalanced. We find ourselves struggling to just stay up. Then we remember the words of Jesus. I've come that you may have life, and that you may have it abundantly. But let's be honest. This ain't the abundant life. I can't walk straight. I can't even keep my balance. Then I remember his words. Come to me, all you who are weary and worn out, and I will give you rest. And that's what I want. So I say, Jesus, please, if you are willing, take this baggage from me, because I'm miserable and I can't live like this anymore. Please, take it. And you know what? He takes it.